In today's Illustrator tutorial, I'm going to explain to you what a Pantone color is, but also how to use them in Illustrator and how to convert other color libraries to a Pantone color. What is up, people? Welcome back to Satori Graphics, home of graphic design content right here on YouTube. If you enjoy this Illustrator Pantone color tutorial, let me know with a like and a comment, and of course, share this video to somebody else. Pantone colors are pre-mixed ink swatches, universally known. A designer is able to select the exact color tones, say for example, in a logo design, and use them in their work. This is very similar to using color swatches of paint from your local hardware store in order to select the color of your wall at home. And just like the paint swatches at a hardware store, spot colors have a unique numeric code, C for coated and U for uncoated. Pantone coated colors are best for glossy paper prints, whereas uncoated are best suited for matte print finishes. Pantone colors allow for great accuracy when choosing colors and then the very same colors printing out how you intend them to across all methods of print. While it's true that spot colors are extremely accurate when it comes to traditional printing, there might be some issues when it comes to converting colors for web-based use. So that is what Pantone colors are. How do you use them for your logo designs? In Illustrator, if you open up the color window and select an object or design, you can switch between modes such as CMYK and RGB. If you want to start a design from scratch using Pantone colors, here's how. And then after that, I'll show you how to convert a design to Pantone. Open the swatches window and then access the Pantone color books like so. You see that there are Pantone coated and uncoated, as I mentioned before. These are the most popular Pantone choices out there. Now you can pick a Pantone color from the selection and make a design using it. You can check the Pantone ID in the color window, or you can hover your cursor over the Pantone color in the swatch window. Next in this Illustrator Pantone color tutorial, how to convert a design that is already a CMYK color mode to Pantone. My logo design here is currently in CMYK, but we can convert it to Pantone color very easily. Select all of your artwork that is a block color, and then go up to Edit, Edit Colors, and then Recolor Artwork. We can access the Pantone color books as we did before. Once you find them, click OK, and Illustrator will match the closest Pantone color to your logo or graphic design as possible. So that is today's Illustrator Pantone color tutorial brought to you by Satori Graphics. Did you find it useful? If so, let me know in the comment section below, and don't forget to like and share on this video. Thanks to all of my main contributors who do comment, like and share my tutorials. You guys know who you are, so thanks a lot. And until next time, design your future today. Peace.